In this video, I want to show how to make a simple macro. In a previous video, I showed this how to use the now function to make a time, date, stamp. Now I want, and there are quite a few steps that you had to do. I want to show how to record a macro that will do all those steps automatically. So I want to do it on a new fresh sheet. So I go to sheet 2. Record a macro, you click on Tools, Macro, record a new macro. It asks for a name. I'm going to put in time, date. There's special restrictions on this name. It cannot have any spaces in it and certain punctuations you can't use. Now, for a shortcut key, I want to put in Shift D. That means to run the macro from the keyboard. If I press Control Shift D, it will run this macro for me. So I click OK, and now whatever keystrokes I put into the computer, Excel will remember them, and it'll repeat those keystrokes whenever I run the macro. So I want to start in this cell here and type date, time, stamp, and then I want to go down one cell, and here I will put the now function. Click on now, and you notice that this column's not wide enough to put in the time and date, so I double click on this to automatically make the column wide enough for it. And now this is a volatile function, and I want to fix it so it'll be that date and time. So I go click and edit copy, and then I go back to edit paste special, and I paste the values. And now I also have to click return so that this is not in the edit memory anymore. And there's the date and time stamp. Now I go back to tools to stop recording the macro, and I say stop recording, and there I should have the macro. To try it out, I'm going to go on to the next sheet, and to run the macro, I'm going to go to tools, macro, select my macro, that's the only one I have, and click run, and there it printed date, timestamp, and the date and time. Now, that was running the macro from the menu bar. I can also run the macro from the keyboard. So let me delete these so that you can see it from the keyboard, and I'm going to press Control Shift D, and that runs the macro as well. Okay, in subsequent videos I'm going to talk a lot more about macros and various things you can do with them and how to edit them, but this is all I wanted to show for this video.